lost my mind, but could ya please help me find it? They talk about the golden old, I should remind them, I shift the culture. I left the ulcer on the bullshit that they label it rap shit. It's out of order, I alter. Hey man, say man, it's your boy Rob back at it again with another bang. Hey yo, this is a heavily requested video we have here. Now, when we hit 30,000 subscribers, I'm gonna drop my top 10 list. We done had a bunch of GOAT debates, you know what I'm saying? Greatest of all time. Everybody got their own opinion. Everybody, you know what I'm saying, feel the way they feel. And that's why I love the debate, because at the end of the day, these is all the greatest players. Now, before I drop my list, I wanted to go to the leader in sports, ESPN, and see who they say is the top 10 NBA players of all time. But on top of that, I want to see everybody that be rocking with my videos, everybody that be in the comments talking that talk, I want to know y'all's top 10 NBA players. Now, if you strapped for time, put your top 5 or top 3, but this video is top 10. So let's see whose comment gets the most upvotes. Put your top 10 list, or if you agree with ESPN, you know what I'm saying, put that in the comments. But either way, when we hit 30K, which will be real soon, by the way, you know what I mean? We can look back on this video and see how close my list is to ESPN and y'all's list, all right? If you're new here, I go by the name of Ra. You know what I'm saying? We react to the legends and we take lessons from the legends, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, greatness is greatness, and we could take a lesson from any of the 10 people on this list. But we about to go through the list and see what ESPN had to say about the 10 greatest NBA players of all time. Subscribe if you enjoy my content. Drop a like if you love the NBA and you remember the golden era. And let's go. All right, well, we're here. ESPN. They ranked the top 74 NBA players of all time. I think this was last year. It was the 74th anniversary of the NBA. So we're here. And number 10, we're starting with Big Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal, the most dominant player that I think I've ever seen. Who stopped, you know what I'm saying, Shaq? I think the only competition Shaq got for the most dominated player is Wilt. You know what I'm saying? But them two, you can't go wrong with either one. They dominated an era. They could not be stopped. One-on-one, how do you stop Shaq other than fouling him? You know what I'm saying? Shaq Diesel put up crazy numbers and was, he was just, not only was he just bigger than everybody, but he was skilled. There's a lot of people that's, you know what I'm saying, tall, but they not sturdy. Shaq was athletic, quick, you know what I'm saying, defense, post game, like all in one, you know what I'm saying? Career stats, 23.7 points per game, 10.9 rebounds per game, 2.3 blocks. Now, if he would have retired sooner, them numbers is probably sky higher than that, you feel me? Let's see who got number 9, the late, great Kobe Bean Bryant. Rest in peace to Kobe, man. Hey, I don't even gotta say much about Kobe Bean. Y'all already know. This the second coming of Michael Jordan. That boy Kobe is, you know what I mean? The Mamba mentality is something that anybody in their life can take inspiration from. You know what I'm saying? If you got a goal that you need to reach, if you want to watch greatness, if you want to hear greatness, if you want to, you know, feel greatness just from watching an interview or watching a game and just looking at the passion that Kobe played the game with, and you study your life after that, you will be successful. You know what I mean? Mid-range game, post game, three-point shot, athleticism, left-handed, for just, man, 81 points in the game. Do I gotta say Mo? Rest in peace to the late great Kobe Bean. 25 points per game, 5.2 rebounds per game, 4.7 assists per game, 1.4 steals per game, and 1.4 threes per game. And on top of that, he played for the Lakers for his whole career of 20 years, man. True legend indeed. Who we got up next? Speaking of legends that played with the same team, we got Timmy Duncan. Now, a lot of people will say these is interchangeable. Kobe and Tim Duncan were interchangeable, but the thing that Tim Duncan got is that he's the greatest power forward of all time. So he's the number one greatest at his position. So I think that's what gives him the push on this list. Tim Duncan is just, you know, I think I took Tim for granted, you know, Because during this era, it was a lot of excitement. It was the AIs of the world, the Vince Carters of the world. You know what I'm saying? The T-Max of the world. You know, those type of players. And you don't really appreciate the fundamentals when, well, I didn't when I was a youngin'. And you know what I mean? It just seemed like he was going to just be balling. You know what I mean? You knew what Timmy was going to do. He wasn't the flashiest player. But if you need to teach somebody how to be great, a great teammate, how to be a fundamentally sound, this is who you show him, Tim Duncan. The greatest power forward of all time. You can argue it if you want, but I don't think there's no denying. You feel me? 19 points per game, 10.8 rebounds per game, 3 assists per game, and 2.2 blocks per game. And he had a 19-year career off of the San Antonio Spurs and 5 rings, I believe. Who we got up next? The legend, Larry Legend Bird. I ain't even got to say too much about number 33 on the Celtics. Y'all already know the vibes. But just in case you don't, you know what I'm saying? I mean, hey, we was talking about the Mamba mentality not too long ago. This dude was the Mamba mentality, and he was a trash talker on top of that. And he was injured before his career even got started. And he got 3 MVPs in a row. And he got rings while Magic and Jordan was in the league. And Jordan never beat him in the playoffs. You know what I'm saying? And without Larry Bird, I don't think Magic and Jordan would have reached their peak. You know what I'm saying? And in my opinion, Larry Bird is up there as one of the greatest of all time for sure. And you know what I mean? Shooter, mid-range, just a pure game. And he had heart. Larry Bird is the embodiment of heart. All the injuries that he sustained, he was still able to do what he did. And that's greatness, you ask me. 24.3 points per game, 10 rebounds per game. He averaged a double-double. I didn't know that. 6.3 assists per game and 1.7 steals per game. He did it on both sides. And he also played for the Boston Celtics. Only one team, 1979-92. Who we got next? Wilt the Stilt Chamberlain. He was breaking records on and off the court. You feel me? Wilt was going crazy with the numbers, man. I don't know if he was just like, let me see how high. He was so competitive. He was like, let me see how many points I could drop on your head at any given time. 100-point game. He averaged 50 on a season. How did that even happen, bro? I can't imagine somebody getting 50, bro. Who was guarding Wilt, bro? How y'all let this man light y'all up for 50, bro? Side segue. I know y'all looking at my tabs like, bro, this is crazy. I'm in grind mode right now. I'm on that road to 200K. I'm grinding. These is all reactions for y'all. So go ahead, if you rock with the video, hit that like and subscribe right now, because we just getting started. What else can I say about Wilt? Just dominant, bro. Like, just dominant, you know? Only 2 NBA championships, but as far as just being solo and just killing the competition, that's what Wilt did. Rest in peace. 30.1 points per game, 22.9 rebounds per game, and 4.4 assists per game. He was dropping a couple of dimes. Number 5, we got Magic Johnson. Irvin Magic Johnson, to be correct. This dude, I mean, what do I need to say? The greatest point guard of all time? Would have broke all types of records if his career wasn't cut short due to illness. But I mean, showtime. This dude played 1-5. He played center in the finals and went off. Like, you went from point guard dropping dimes to playing center and getting a dub. You brought the best out of Kareem. The Showtime Lakers, 5 rings. Ain't no telling, man. I mean, Magic was a beast. Magic and Larry had a legendary rivalry. He top 5 on the list. I mean, if you was making a point guard, you would, I mean, this is the template right here. You take everything Magic got and put Steph Curry shooting on that, and you have probably the best player of all time, honestly. But you know what I'm saying? So what did Magic average? Also, all-time Laker. He actually came back in 1996. I didn't know that. He only played 12 years initially, and then I think that's when the illness happened, and then he came back 1996. Didn't know that. Interesting. But, yeah, I don't know much about that 1996 season, so learn something new every day. 19.5 rebounds per game, 19.5 points per game, 7.2 rebounds per game, 11.2 assists per game, 1.9 steals per game. Not only was he a beast on offense, but he was a beast on defense too. And like I said, he took Showtime to new heights, Larry Bird, and Michael Jeffrey Jordan, who I think might be coming up on this list pretty soon. All right, Number four, we got Mr. 11 Rings himself. That's Bill Russell, man. Probably one of the most underrated players just because he don't have the stats that we talk about, you know? He played in the same era of Wilt, and you know, the flashiness is with Wilt, but this is probably the greatest teammate ever, bruh. If y'all ever seen Bill Russell, he just be chilling, bruh. He was coaching at one point, and he ain't say too much, but he was in his bag at all times and making sure that he put in the hard work. You know, he kind of I guess he's like the mold of Dennis Rodman, but Dennis Rodman before Dennis Rodman, just putting in that work, you know what I'm saying? And leading by example, you know? That's what Bill Russell mean to me. And he got more rings than he got fingers, you know what I'm saying? He got to put two on his pinky, you know what I'm saying? That's real player right there, you know what I mean? Also, 11 rings, he played from 56 to... excuse me. He played from 1956 to 1969, all for the Boston Celtics. Listen to this, man. Listen to this stat line. 15.1 points per game, 22.5 rebounds per game. Somebody box that man out, all right? Anybody. 22 rebounds is crazy, bruh. And 4.3 assists per game. I actually just reacted to some Bill Russell footage, and bro was dropping dimes like this. You would never know that he was a dime dropper, but his passes was somebody cutting over the back like that a lot of the times. Beast. Number three, we got the all-time scoring champ, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Also very underrated, I would say. Has the most unblockable move ever. 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 The skyhook. Unguardable. This dude was a bucket. He's he was also like an activist. He stood for, I mean, to this day, he's a genius. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, I'd love to interview Kareem Abdul-Jabbar just to see what advice he got for the youngest, man. Like, I want to know his take on greatness, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't know, he was a bookworm, bro. But he was on the court, you couldn't stop this man. I'm pretty sure he played all 4 years in college too. If I'm not mistaken, he won titles in college, titles in the, you know what I'm saying, in the NBA and in high school. Like something crazy like that, the all-time winner or something. I'm sure it's on here. And he played for the Milwaukee Bucks for the beginning of his career and then the Lakers for 14 years. 20-year career, averages of 24.6 points per game, 11.2 rebounds per game, 3.6 assists per game. Him and Magic, that's a dynamic duo. Imagine if they both was on their prime at the same time. Oh my goodness, you couldn't stop that. Just like you couldn't stop that hook shot. But let me see. Six championships. Let's see. With the first and last coming 17 years apart. That's crazy. 15 All-NBA teams, unstoppable. Skyhook, portal, Cito. They got LeBron at number two. Oh, no. You know what? I'm going to say my opinion for my video. Get your boy up to 30,000. Hit that subscribe if you're rocking with my commentary. I think this is the littest content on YouTube. You feel me? That flavor with that basketball commentary. I don't even think. This is the littest basketball content on earth. You feel what I mean? But we got LeBron James coming at number two. And I mean, you know what I'm saying? Number two is straight. You know, I say my commentary for the next video, you know, the 30K video. But we got to get there first. I mean, what you got to say about Bron, man? This is like Magic Johnson, but posterizing, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? This is, hey, man, LeBron James, bro, passing. I feel like he make his teammates better. Basketball IQ on 1,000, you know what I mean? And great defender. 1 through 5, most of the time 1 through 4, but 1 through 5 when he was at his, you know what I'm saying? All them straight finals, you know what I mean? First back, I mean, what can you, you know? LeBron had to grow, you know, mentally, but just a beast, bro. Just a beast. Dunking on everybody, blocking shots, guarding the best player on the other team, you know, number two on the list. And I wonder who's number one. You know what? I'm going to skip this. We ain't even going to talk about it. Nah, I'm just playing. I'm just playing, man. Hey, LeBron a machine, though. But we got another monster. Michael Jeffrey Jordan. I ain't even surprised. You know what I'm saying? I kind of had a feeling he was going to be number one. You know what I mean? What can I say about Michael Jeffrey Jordan? Mentality, skill set, determination, defense, and clutch gene. Just a bucket, bro. Every time I watch Michael Jordan, I'm like, how he do that? You know, the way I feel about Magic and LeBron's passing, That's how I feel about Jordan's scoring ability, his clutch ability, and just the ability to the defensive plays he makes as well. Like, he's just all around. Like, my opinion is, man, you can't stop Mike, bro. You can't stop Mike. I ain't saying, I told y'all in my previous videos, my list is a little different. I'm not going to say where it's different at just yet, but I can't take nothing away. Look at this play right here real quick. Look at the defense. And he got a bucket on his play. They was tackling this man and he was getting buckets. They knocked him down and he got bigger, then he went and got more buckets. You feel me? MJ. Oh, did I do LeBron's stats? No, I didn't. Real quick, LeBron, 27.1 points per game, I think I did do that. My bad, y'all. My bad. Cut that. He was getting tackled. They had to make rules for Jordan. 6-0 in the finals. And never went to a game 7 in the finals. Y'all taught me that after I reacted to the Ultimate mixtape. So, fire. Jordan is fire. Y'all know how that go, man. Legend. They call him Black Jesus. Chicago Bulls for the first half of his career retired, so his numbers would have been even more crazy if he didn't. Played for the Wizards. I just reacted to some of that footage. He was lighting them up even in the Wizards jersey. It's kind of, impressive. Very impressive what he was doing even at 38, I think. You know what I'm saying? They gave him the GOAT title on ESPN. I hope y'all enjoyed my commentary. Shout out to my producers. Hold up. Let me fix my screen here. All right. Technical difficulties. All right. Yeah, okay. All right. Consider it fixed. So, yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed this list. If y'all did, let me know by dropping a like and subscribing. I have a full playlist. You think of your favorite player, think of Rod Reacts right after it. Type it in the search bar after this video. I guarantee I got a reaction to it. Guarantee. But before you leave, let me know your top 3 or your top 5 or your top 10. You feel me? Whoever gets the most upvotes, when I drop my 30K video and my personal top 10 list, I will shout out the top comment on this video. So show some love in the comments. If you made it to the end of the video, I know y'all see me rocking the merch. Comment O-N-L-Y-F-A-M. That's only fam. And that's to the finish, man. Hope y'all doing good and staying safe. Hope y'all enjoyed this certified banger. And I see you on the next episode. Stay tuned. We about to run it up. Y'all already know, man. It's rock and I'm out. It is. And yeah, we still blazing. Throw a flow immaculate. Gas mask, trash bags full of that Cali Kush. Need more cash flow, these boys smoking regular. Claim that they the plug, door man, get your hustle up. Circle of bosses around me, cross cover my juggler.